you had the Afghan war. We did on the last Trends Journal, the summer edition, we did a piece on George Bush's his 9/11 evening speech and the one several days later. And I wrote that only a madman would speak these words, and only a nation dumbstruck with fear would believe them, and believe they did. There was not one fact in his speech that took us to war against Afghanistan. Not one. And everybody waved those flags and tied yellow ribbons to everything that didn't move. Now we're in the longest war in American history, and for what? A total failure? Oh, not for what? You made the point. Hey, the opium biz is really booming now. It was at zero when the Taliban were there or thereabouts, way below. And let's not forget, who created all this? Oh, that peace-loving peanut farmer. Yeah, you remember him, Jimmy Carter. Oh, yeah, that great guy who invented the Mujahideen. Yeah, Mujahideen, Al-Qaeda, Al-Nusra, ISIS. Yeah, one generation after another. Created by Carter, Brzezinski, and all of the other psychopaths and sociopaths that are running the show to beat the Russians. You remember that one. And then, of course, there's the Iraq War, built on lies. Well, let's just call them the facts were wrong. Saddam Hussein did not have weapons of mass destruction nor ties to Al-Qaeda. But yet we went in anyway, and then they roll out these losers, man, like Cheney and Rumsfeld and Wolfowitz, and they repeat the same stupid lies, and the prostitutes bow down, suck up, and swallow them. The world is better off without Saddam Hussein. Oh, yeah, man, Iraq's a lovely place. It's beautiful. Oh, and let's not forget Libya. Oh, Libya, oh, Libya. Who did that one? The Nobel Peace Prize winner. Yeah, Obama. You remember that humanitarian mission brought to us by Hillary Clinton, Samantha Powers, and Susan Rice and Barack Obama destabilized the entire area. Yeah. They're telling people now in Benghazi to leave because it's a free-for-all. And it's spreading into Tunisia, into Egypt, into Mali, all over. People are flooding into Europe. You want to talk about an immigration problem? Yeah, thanks to the United States and its NATO flunkies. So every war that they have taken us to has not only caused more disaster, it's drained our treasury.
And that's by design, Gerald. That's totally by design, to get us into these wars, to spread us out, and then we become ripe picking for the bank. The bankers can come in and just do whatever they want to us. And it really is disgusting. It really is disgusting. Now, where do you see with this new crop of senators and congressmen coming in, it looks like there's going to be a GOP majority. Where do you see that aside from Africa? Do you think we're going to start going into Africa with, and especially in West Africa, where we're already established a beachhead thanks to Ebola? Where do you see us going in after this?
Well, what they're going to do, one of the things they're going to do, they'll probably kill that Iran deal that they're trying to do now, that Obama administration is trying to push through. And again, you know, I just want to jump back to something you said about the taxes in Texas.
Yeah.
And how, you know, they're hurting the little people while the big guys get all the breaks. You saw that guy, Obama, the other Obama with the yell in it. The guy that, you know, from Microsoft bought one of those basketball teams. Yeah, that guy, he's worth, you know, several billion dollars, like maybe 15. They gave him a $1 billion tax break for buying it. And then you pick up the news this week. The guy Malone that owns Liberty Media, the huge one. He gets tax breaks all over the place, too. It is a banking takeover. And you're bringing it back when you said, yeah, this is a banking deal, puts us deeper in debt, and then we have to work for the multinationals, and they pay us nothing. So what we're doing with Occupy Peace right here, and you were here from the, by the way, we own three of those buildings on the historic corner. What we're doing is we're going back to the roots of the founding fathers, every one of them, beginning with Washington, a real man, not one of these little boys that can't fight their way out of a paper bag or play a mediocre game of golf and like to play basketball, or over there in England, maybe cricket. This is a real man that fought in the war, Washington. He said in his farewell address, no foreign entanglements. Franklin, no foreign entanglements. Madison, Adams, one after another. And guess what? The world was at war then too. But they built America. And I'm tired of these people saying, oh, they did this, they were terrible. If you don't like it here, leave. This country became great because of the principles and the Constitution that was developed here that so much of the once free world used to copy as a template for their freedom. Of course, here it's been taken away from us, but that's another story. Right across from me, right on the other side of this camera, is the courthouse. This was the first capital of New York State that the Constitution of New York was written. Four Supreme Court justices came with jurors there, including John Jay. 90% of America's Constitution came from the Constitution from colonial Kingston, New York. We're bringing back democracy. The seeds of democracy was sown here, and six words killed it. Harvard, Princeton, Yale, bullets, bombs, and banks. And the first criminal, may he rot in hell, who sold us out was the Princeton president, Woodrow Wilson, who not only gave us the Federal Reserve, he also put us into World War I against everything that this nation believed in.
And I was just about to bring that up.
And who's running the show now.
I was going to bring that up, Gerald. That's when we got into our first big foreign entanglement after we had, you know, developed our sovereignty, was World War I. And that was the beginning of this long slide of being beholden to the Federal Reserve, being beholden to giant banks who aren't elected. It's just and the giant military industrial complex now, that they get paid either way, whether we win the war or lose the war, whether we continue the war, they're making their money. And the people working in that industry are getting paid. But it's not anything that's producing anything. It's not a space industry. We've pretty much given that up for, you know, a couple rockets now that can't even get off the ground. It's just a disgrace that we can build these amazing weapons that can be fired from 20, 30 miles away, can pinpoint a house, and yet we can't get rockets off the ground now. I mean, it's a total disgrace.
People in Detroit can't pay their water bills.
Yeah.
I mean, come on. So Occupy, I mean, it's you nailed it. So that's what we're saying. And again, I really want to stay with this Harvard, Princeton, Yale. I'm tired of these arrogant people all in politics telling us what to do and how to do it. Go up and down the list. The program is there. They're all club members, whether it's the DC gang or the Wall Street criminal operation. It's the same club, and we're not in it. So what we're doing with Occupy Peace is going back to the roots of democracy, believing in the founding fathers. Oh, and by the way, another man, not like these little boys in the White House that we've had, the Clintons, Bushes, and Obamas. A real man, Eisenhower, in his farewell address, warns the nation that the military-industrial complex is robbing us of the future of the children, the sweat of the laborers, and the genius of the scientists. And you nailed it with these high-class weaponry that they're making. Could you imagine if those trillions were invested in we the people? So Occupy Peace, the motive is no foreign entanglements, rebuild America, and here's where it's going to be different from anywhere of any rally ever seen before. We're going to give takeaways. This isn't a thing to go, yeah, 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 and then you go home and forget about it. We're putting together a battle plan for peace, because I would rather fight for peace than die for war. And I'm not a pacifist, as you well know.
You're a close combat practitioner.
Exactly. I'll kill anybody that tries to kill me.
I totally agree. Hey, let's end here on the Trends Journal. You have this cycles of history. Why don't you give people a quick history lesson of the different stages that societies go through, and what stage are we in right now?
Them. You got them there in front of you.
I got them in front of me. I got the warrior stage, the intellectual stage, the merchant stage, and the chaos stage. Now, where are we at right now?
We're in the chaos stage.
All right.
As I said, the warriors are gone. The intellectuals were the founding fathers. These guys that are in place now know nothing about anything. We're in the chaos stage. And by the way, one of the things that I would love is for you, Alex Jones, and the crew to come to the Four Corners on May 2nd, 2015, and broadcast live for OccupyPeace.us. And anybody could go to that site, by the way, and sign up. Because our future is on the line. I'm a trend forecaster, and I believe in the trend, the prophecy that Einstein, going back to the chaos theory of the cycles, Einstein said, I don't know how the Third World War will be fought, but the fourth will be fought with sticks and stones. And that's where they're leading us. One losing war after another, and now they're getting big.
I totally agree. It is a crazy world that we're becoming into, the chaos that we've created by taking down these evil dictators that were, you know, essentially keeping the different tribes under control. Gaddafi, yeah, he was a socialist, but you know what? He was feeding his people. They had power. They were getting water. They were doing deals with the Chinese. He wanted to create an African Union. So what do? We take him out. Same thing with Saddam Hussein. Oh, yeah, we sold him weapons of mass destruction. He has weapons of mass destruction, so we got to go in and take him out. But, you know, we don't talk about the weapons of mass destruction that we sold him. And then it came out that we found weapons of mass destruction there, but we didn't want to say anything about it because they had our stamp of approval on it. They were all made in the USA. So, of course, they're never going to mention that stuff. I mean, it's just ridiculous. And we keep buying into it. We keep buying into the next war. We buy into the next fake terrorist attack. It just continues on a cycle. And like you said, we are in the chaos stage right now in our history, and it's filled with drones and cameras. And guess what? We're all walking around with cameras. It looks like they're about to bring out Greg Abbott. Gerald, do you want to stay with us while they bring him out and comment on what's going on, or do you want us to let you go for the evening?
Why don't we let me go for the evening?
All right. Well, tell us where we can find more of the Trends Journal. And did you see Anthony Frieda got his piece of artwork accepted, his 9/11 truth piece, into the 9/11 museum? Did you see that bit of news that was out there?
Isn't that great news? Yeah, Anthony Frieda is great. Yeah, and of course he's an illustrator for us, and you guys use him as well. And I know he's been on with Alex. Trendsjournal.com, trendsjournal.com. It's the only place where you read history before it happens. And for all of those of you that want to fight for peace, bring home the troops, seal the borders, rebuild America, OccupyPeace.us, sign up, give us your comments, and let's turn this around. Let's bring it back to we the people and take it out of the hands of the gang of 535 that they call Congress.
All right, and I'll leave you with that. Gerald, thanks for everything you do. And you know, anytime, we love having you on. You're a great breath of fresh air to just wake people up with some energy, you know? A guy your age still out there screaming about the system and the way things should be and the where we've gone wrong and everything else included. And thanks for joining us here on our live midterm election coverage. It was a pleasure having you on.
Thanks a lot for having me.
All right. There goes Gerald Celente. And you can find out more about him at trendsjournal.com.